Hello and welcome to this thank you video. A thank you to you, my awesome community of 1,000+ people. So just a huge welcome to everyone. I think I'm still in shock. I think I'm still like processing it, but I am just very grateful for it. So thank you so much. If you are one of my newest friends in this community, then please just leave a comment down below saying hi. I really love to get to know the different people who make up this community. And in case I haven't said community enough, I'm actually gonna count it. There's gonna be a counter up here. We've actually, by virtue of reaching 1,000 subscribers, we've unlocked the community tab on YouTube, which is just so exciting. So please keep a lookout there for polls that I'm gonna need your input on, sneak peeks of upcoming videos, and all your advice and your opinion on different things. Please keep an eye out there. I really look forward to more interaction with you. So today's We Celebrate / milestone video is a little bit different. I've gotten a lot of questions about what computer do I use, and I think that that's just a product of WeSims finding its place as a trusted technical source for simmers. And naturally, a lot of people have wanted to know, well, what computer do I use? What are my peripherals? What do I use for content creation? Things like that. I will leave links to all parts of my setup in the description. And if you want to see it all in like one place, just in a nice, like neat way, definitely check out kit.co/WeSims. As always, if you like this video, please let me know by leaving a thumbs up. And if you want to see more content just like this, please subscribe and hit the notification bell if you want to see that content as soon as I upload. So as a disclaimer, as we're getting into this simming, streaming, content creation, beastly little corner of mine, I need to say that you don't need this to run The Sims 4. Please do not think that you need everything in the setup to run The Sims 4 on ultra settings, or for streaming, or for editing, whatever. That is what I've built this for, but it's also a large portion of the setup is just indulging myself and building what I think is my dream setup. The equivalent of someone having a dream car. And I need to put the word overkill in the title for this exact reason. So note to self, overkill. This is an overkill Sims 4 gaming setup. With that said, however, it is really nice to play The Sims 4 and record and have 0.0% dropped frames at the same time. That's pretty nice. I'm not gonna say that my experience isn't beautiful. It is. You just don't need everything that I have here, and you don't need to play at 4K in order to experience a gorgeous game. So the way I'm gonna approach my setup is I'm gonna start with my computer itself, like everything that's inside the box that is my computer, then my peripherals, and then my content creation things. So without further ado, meet Anubis. Anubis's CPU is the AMD Ryzen 7 3700X, and it is housed in a beautiful Asus Prime X470 Pro motherboard. My GPU is the EVGA GeForce RTX 2070 Super XC Ultra Gaming Edition, and my RAM is probably one of my most inspiring parts of my build. It is the G-Skill Trident Z Royal 32GB with a 3200MHz frequency. I love this RAM. I sometimes just stare at my computer looking at this RAM. It is stunning. My CPU cooler is the Noctua NH-U12S in the Chromex Black Edition, and it comes with a 120mm single fan. And it is shrouded by the Noctua NA-HC2 in Chromax White. I have four different storage options in this computer, two of which are NVMe, two of which are SATA hard drives. So my storage option that my computer boots from is the Mushkin Helix L 500GB M.2 2280 PCIe NVMe. And this is just such a fun time to do anything on my computer that uses this drive. It is amazing to see the transfer speeds. Then my storage that I use for my WeSims related everything and all my recordings and whatever is the Intel 660p series, and it is also an M.2 NVMe 1TB PCIe. Then I have two SATA hard drives. One is a hybrid drive. It's a Seagate Momentus XT, It is a very old hard drive, also in addition to my Samsung 750 gigabyte something. I can't even remember like what model it is. And both of these came out of my previous gaming laptop, and they come up to about 1.5 terabytes in total, and I use that for storing like my documents, like from my university days, a lot of my lecture notes are there and things like that. I actually am not using that fourth one because I don't have a straight SATA cable for it just yet. Until then, it's actually just stuck onto the side of my computer with the Seagate Momentus, but it's not actually connected to my motherboard, so it's decorative at this point. My PSU is the Corsair RM750X, and it is a 750-watt gold 80+ efficiency PSU from Corsair, and I have a network card that fits into one of my PCIe slots, and that is just so that I have Wi-Fi access as well when need be. My case is the NZXT H510. It is in white and has a beautiful window on the side so I can stare at my computer constantly. My computer actually used to be on the floor, and then for this video, when I started shooting some of the B-roll, I realized that I need to see it constantly. And it just is like that. My two case fans are the Noctua NF-A14, so it's 140mm, and the Noctua NF-F12, so 120mm. So now we're going to move into my peripherals. And first up is my primary monitor. It is the Samsung S32 R750 32-inch 4K Ultra HD monitor with a space-saving design. And what that basically means is that this monitor clamps onto my desk, and so it has like a very small footprint, and I can actually move it as high or as low as need be, and it actually is really nice just ergonomically. It is complemented by my Dell SE2219H. It's a 21.5-inch full HD monitor. Both of these have standard refresh rates of 60Hz, and it is actually an IPS monitor, which basically means that the way that it showcases colors is very like true to what those colors actually are. My speakers are the Logitech G560 speakers, and I just love them. They are stunning. They are RGB as well. My speakers are just, they're part of this look, and it makes me very happy to stare at them as well. And they have decent sound quality. I don't listen to a lot of music with them. It's more just for gameplay related things. Getting onto the rest of my peripherals, I don't like wires. So my setup is wireless as much as possible. So my keyboard is the Logitech MX Keys wireless keyboard. My mouse is the Logitech MX Master 3 mouse, and I use the Logitech MX Palm Rest in this configuration. I play simulation games exclusively. I play The Sims 4, I play Cities Skylines, I play things that don't need hyper responsive keyboards and super high refresh rate monitors. My mouse pad is an Oracle mouse mat. I don't know much about it. To be honest, I forgot that it's a part of my setup. I literally just bought the cheapest one that I could find. I'm still deciding whether I want to invest in a large mouse mat. Until that point, I'm quite happy with just using it. It does the job. My headset, and this is one thing that I really want to upgrade in the future, but it's really good quality, so I'll leave it for now, is the Sennheiser GSP-301 in black and white. As you can see, I have a black and white vibe going for me here, and it is one of the wired aspects of my setup. It's allowed to survive another day until I can afford something like the Arctis Pro from SteelSeries, because that is just stunning. But until then, it has excellent sound quality, really comfortable. Unless you wear it for like 6 hours, then it actually gets very uncomfortable and your ears need like a break, or my ears need a break. Until that point, I really have been enjoying them. Another somewhat random piece of peripherals is my chair. I use an ergonomic chair because it's really important. Gaming chairs are not made to support you for long, like for long periods of time. So if you actually intend on sitting in your gaming chair for gaming marathons and things like that, seriously consider rather getting an ergonomic chair. It is just better for your back health. When it comes to my content creation setup, there are a couple things that are works in progress here, and this is actually where most of my upgrades will be in future. I don't plan on upgrading my computer. I think Anubis is perfect just the way he is. There might be some things I change, like I'm planning on getting some custom cables. I'm still deciding on a color for them, but Anubis is probably going to stay the way he is on the inside, and that is why I invested in as many expensive parts as I did, so that I don't have to look at upgrading him for a while. What you're going to be seeing over the course of this channel's journey really is that I'm going to be upgrading my things that I make content with, because I really love making content for you guys. At the moment I have a fairly basic setup, so I use the Logitech C922 Pro. I also use the Samson Q2U microphone. It is a very affordable mic. It is one of the most highly recommended mics from Epos Vox, who's a very, very knowledgeable person in this sphere. And I'm planning on keeping it for quite a while. Other little things, I have a tripod with an LED light, and I also use the tripod with a little attachment for my phone, which is how I shot some of the B-roll today. And a very new addition to my setup is my little orchid here. I love it. Thanks, husband. So with all of that said, I really hope that you enjoyed this setup tour of my little content creation nook. I hope that my setup inspires you as much as it inspires me every day. Thank you so much for watching once again, and I'll see you in the next video. Soul.